Welcome to Understand the Math. This video is part of a series of videos on linear algebra and its applications and covers section 1.10 on difference equations. I'll teach you what a difference equation is, and then we'll walk through two example problems where we'll model two different types of dynamical systems. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can highlight and fill in as you watch this video. Let's begin by talking about difference equations and what types of problems can be solved with difference equations. A difference equation just describes the difference between successive terms in a sequence. It's used to model situations where changes occur in steps, and we call these steps discrete time intervals. A difference equation is a discrete counterpart to a differential equation. With differential equations, changes occur continuously instead of at discrete time intervals, as with difference equations. The discrete time interval could be a day, a month, a week, a year, or any other type of time interval. A difference equation can be written as vector x sub k plus 1 is equal to a matrix A times vector x sub k. A is called a transition matrix, and x sub k contains information about the state of the dynamic system at time step k. Let's now see how difference equations can be used to model population dynamics. We're going to see how to model the population dynamics of frogs, and we're going to focus on two life stages. We're going to focus on the juvenile or tadpole stage, and then the adult stage. The variables used in a difference equation are called state variables, and they contain the information about the dynamical system. The state variables in the problem that we're going to be looking at are t sub k, which is the number of tadpoles at time step k, and then f sub k, which is the number of adult frogs at time step k. X sub k contains the information about our system, so we'll let it equal a vector with components t sub k and f sub k. Vector x sub 0 is the initial state of the system, and we'll let that be equal to t sub 0 and f sub 0. T sub 0 and f sub 0 are the number of tadpoles and frogs that are present at the beginning. Population dynamics are going to tell us about the life stages of the tadpoles and the adult frogs. The population at the next time step depends on the current populations of tadpoles and frogs. The frogs produce tadpoles, and the tadpoles mature into frogs. The survival rate of tadpoles is equal to R. R is the percentage of tadpoles that stay tadpoles. Tadpoles produced by adult frogs is equal to F. This is a number and not a percentage. Finally, the maturation rate of tadpoles is equal to S. This is the percentage of tadpoles that become adult frogs. T sub k plus 1 represents the number of tadpoles at the next time step. This is going to be equal to R times T sub k, the number of tadpoles that stay tadpoles, plus F times F sub k, the number of tadpoles produced by the adult frogs. F sub k plus 1 is equal to S times T sub k. That's the number of tadpoles that mature into adult frogs, plus 0 times F sub k, because frogs don't produce any frogs. We can write this linear system of equations as a difference equation. Our difference equation is X sub k plus 1 is equal to a matrix A times X sub k. We'll put T sub k plus 1 and F sub k plus 1 into X sub k plus 1, and we'll get the following vector equation. On the left, we have T sub k plus 1 and F sub k plus 1. Then we have our matrix A, and that's going to be these entries. We have an R and an S and an F and a 0. And then we have the vector t sub k and f sub k. I want to teach you an easier way to be able to do this. We can often not write down these equations and instead just write down our matrix A. One way that we can construct A is to write T for tadpole and F for frog here, and then on the left-hand side, T for tadpole and F for frog. We then want to write the entries in this column and then in this column. Our first entry is going to be the percentage of tadpoles that stay tadpoles, and that's going to be R. Our second entry in this column is going to be the percentage of tadpoles that turn into frogs, and that's going to be S. Now let's look at our second column. The first entry in our second column is going to be the number of tadpoles produced by adult frogs, and that's equal to F. And then the last entry in this matrix is the number of frogs produced by frogs, and that's equal to 0. Now that we understand these population dynamics, let's walk through a specific example problem. We're going to assume the following. 60% of tadpoles survive to the next year. That means that R is equal to 0.6. Each adult frog produces 300 tadpoles each year. That tells us that F is equal to 300. And 40% of the tadpoles mature into adult frogs in the next year. That means that S is equal to 0.4. And then we have some more information. Initially, there are 1,000 tadpoles and 200 adult frogs. We're asked to determine the number of tadpoles and adult frogs after the second year. Let's write all this information down. Our T0 is the number of tadpoles initially, and that's 1,000. Our F0 is our initial number of adult frogs, and that's 200. Looking at these equations above, we have T sub K plus 1 is equal to R, which is 0.6 T sub K, plus our F, which is 300, times F sub K. Our F sub K plus 1 is equal to S, which is 0.4 T sub K, plus 0. Our difference equation is going to be X sub K plus 1 is equal to A times X sub K. Let's get some more practice in filling out our matrix A. We have tadpoles and frogs on the top and tadpoles and frogs on the left-hand side. Let's work on our first column. The percentage of tadpoles that stay tadpoles is 0.6, and the percentage of tadpoles that turn into adult frogs is 0.4. Now let's look at our second column. The number of tadpoles produced by frogs is equal to 300, and the number of frogs produced by frogs is 0. So our matrix A is 0.6, 0.4, 300, and 0. Let's now compute the number of tadpoles and frogs after the first year. That's going to be T1 and F1, and it's going to be equal to our matrix A, 0.6, 300, 0.4, and 0. We're going to multiply that by our T0, which we were given was 1,000, and then our F0, which we were given was 200. This answer is then 0.6 times 1,000 plus 300 times 200. That's for our first row. And for our second row, we have 0.4 times 1,000 plus 0. Let's put our answer up here, and that answer is 60,600 on top and 400 for our second component. Let's now determine how many tadpoles and frogs we have after the second year. We have our same matrix A. And now for our vector on the right, we have T1 and F1. So that's going to be 60,600 and then 400. When you do this multiplication, we end up with the following answers. This is the number of tadpoles. And this is the number of adult frogs. Later on in this course, we'll be able to predict the long-term behavior of this linear system by analyzing the eigenvalues of matrix A. Let's now see how difference equations can be used to model fitness dynamics. This problem is different from our previous problem because all the entries in our matrix A will be percentages. We're going to be modeling population fitness levels that change over time. We're going to be focusing on three groups: unfit, fit, and superfit individuals. Our state variables are going to be U sub K, that's the number of unfit individuals at month K. So our time step is going to be months. Our second state variable is F sub K, and it represents the number of fit individuals at month K. And then lastly, we have S sub K, and that's for our super fit individuals at month K. Let's put these state variables into X sub K, and we get X sub K has components U sub K, F sub K, and S sub K. Let's now go over the fitness dynamics. Unfit individuals can remain unfit or improve to fit. Fit individuals can remain fit, regress to unfit, or improve to superfit. Superfit individuals can remain superfit or regress to fit. Notice that they can't regress to unfit. Let's now look at an example problem where we're given percentages of these three different fitness levels. Initially, we have 50% unfit, 30% fit, and then 20% superfit. We want to find the values of individuals in each category after 1 month if the following dynamics apply. We're first going to start by setting up our matrix A. Since we have three categories of individuals, our matrix A is going to be a 3x3 matrix. When setting up A, I'm going to leave room for writing down our categories. So I'm going to make our matrix over here. Our categories are unfit, fit, and superfit. We'll put those at the top. And then we'll also put these on the left-hand side. Let's fill up the first column of our matrix and focus on our first category. Let's highlight that first category. We have 70% of unfit individuals remain unfit, so that's going to be 0.7. And then we have 30% of unfit individuals improve to fit, so that's going to be 0.3. And then we don't have any unfit individuals that jump to superfit, so this next one is going to be a 0. Let's now look at the fit individuals. We have 10% that's going to regress to unfit, 80% that's going to remain fit, and then 10% that's going to improve to superfit. That gives us 0.1, and then 0.8, and then 0.1. Now let's look at our superfit individuals. We have 20% that's going to regress to fit, and then 80% that are going to remain superfit. Our first entry is going to be 0, because no one goes from superfit to unfit. And then our next one is going to be our 0.2, and then our 0.8. I'm now going to show you something that's really important that will help you make sure that you set up your matrix A right. When you're dealing with entries that are percentages or probabilities, each column of A needs to add up to 100% or 1. So 0.7 plus 0.3 is 1. 0.1 plus 0.8 plus 0.1 is 1, and then 0.2 plus 0.8 is 1. And that way you know that you've probably set up your matrix properly. Our difference equation is going to be x sub k plus 1 is equal to A times x sub k. Let's go ahead and put our A down here on our right-hand side. This is what we got from our previous page. We have 0.7, 0.30. We have a 0.1, 0.8, 0.1. And then we have a 0, a 0.2, and a 0.8. We're asked to find the percentages of individuals in each category after 1 month. That means we need to find X sub 1. X sub 1 is going to equal A times X sub 0. Our X sub 1 is equal to U1 F1 S1, and that's going to be equal to our A times our initial number of percentages of individuals in each category. On the previous page, we were told that we had 50% unfit individuals, so we put that in as a 0.5. We had 30% fit individuals, so that's 0.3. And then we had 20% superfit individuals, and that's 0.2. Let's now multiply our matrix times a vector and see what we get. For our first row, we have 0.7 times 0.5 plus 0.1 times 0.3 plus 0. For our second row, we have 0.3 times 0.5 plus 0.8 times 0.3 plus 0.2 times 0.2. And then for our last row, we have 0 plus 0.1 times 0.3 plus 0.8 times 0.2. This gives us values of 0.38 for our first entry, 0.43 for our second entry, and then 0.19 for our last entry or component. This means that after 1 month, 38% of individuals are unfit, 43% are fit, and then 19% are superfit. When you have a matrix A that has percentages or probabilities in it, you always want to make sure that your answers add up to 100%. So we can see that 38% plus 43% plus 19% is definitely 100%. Be sure to check out the next video in this series where you'll learn all about linear transformations.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.